the value of happiness. So nowadays is, today is 29th of September of 2018, and we are in Belgium right now. It's very Western society, it's Europe. One of the values that has been spread on the last years, in part due to positive psychology, which is my specialization, or one of my specializations, is happiness, the value of happiness. So how can we get to a happy life? Yeah, positive psychologists mention philosophers like the quest of happiness, or Aristotle's with these different type of lives, like more hedonistic, into the pleasures, or more meaningful, this eudaimonic. So the point is, for me, I mean, happiness is, let's say, it's a subproduct. It's something can be achieved through peace. For me, truth is a very important value in a more intellectual level, probably, in maybe in a more practical level, or something like closer to reality. But better than happiness, from my personal point of view, is peacefulness. Peacefulness is something like to be happy, to be satisfied, to be fulfilled. So it's a type of happiness of lower emotional intensity. Usually we associate happiness with joy, with moments of high arousal, when we feel more alive. We feel, but in a maybe less conscious way. On the other hand, for me, peacefulness can be this more stable happiness, more long-term fulfillment, more long-term satisfaction. So how can we get there? We need to be conscious of the good moments and the bad moments. Like, we can focus on happiness, focus on pleasures, focus on good moments, but bad moments are gonna strike, and they are gonna strike back. They are always gonna be there. So trying to escape from the negativity will make us unhappy, because we will live with worries. Even, I mean, we can go and watch Netflix and think we are happy. We can have fun for a while and think we are happy. So we can focus on having fun, on looking for good moments. But it's a bit like craving. We can crave for good moments. On the other hand, if we, instead of looking outside, which is what Western society has done, we get more input from Eastern philosophies, when they have focused more on the inner being. So it's more about how the inner being is reacting, how the inner being is reinterpreting what is happening outside. From my point of view, it's more stable way to reach happiness, more astounding, more grounded way to get happiness in the long term. And many people said that I'm very happy, that I laugh a lot. But I'm very close also, and I'm very in touch with my suffering. And I think it's fundamental. So it sounds paradoxical, and it might sound ironic, but the closer you are with your suffering, the closer you are with your sorrows, with your pain, the closer you are with your happiness. Obviously, meditating is the best technique. And it's the technique to get in touch with what's happening in your body in the negative moments. And through understanding what's happening in your body in the negative moments, you can start being more conscious about the positive moments. Many times we are not conscious on the spot, like on the moment when we are having fun. It's more about retrospective view, like, wow, we had very much fun in this party. But when you were at the party, were you really conscious of how fun you were getting? Or your mind was somewhere else, but you were living? So thanks to meditating, we can also start to understand how can we put our mind somewhere else through all our life. So maybe at some point in the future, we can say, wow, all my life was so nice, was so fun, was so beautiful. Because that's the thing, when we suffer, we are very conscious of ourselves. And we could move toward a very deep topic, which is the self. And it's complicated. But to make things shorter and more clear, if this is possible, be closer to your pain, be closer to your sorrows. And you can start moving forward your happiness, start moving forward these good moments of your life in a more conscious way. And breathe in when you are laughing and think like, wow, I'm laughing. And then you will, yeah, you will start sensing your body alive when you are laughing, which is something of probably the best experience you can have. Like laugh consciously, laugh like you are alive. And then you can explore love, which for me love is one of the deepest emotions. And I think it's one of the basic reasons we are here as a human beings, is love. It's like out of, yeah, it's sociality. Out of all the mammals that are out there, we are the most social, we are the most successful. And it's thanks to love. For me, this is basic evolution. 150 people we can have around. And now with the smartphones, we are getting to higher connection, but lower love. So that's the point of our mind, to learn how to expand. How can we expand our love to reach all the people that we can reach with technology? So if we are able to make this 150 people mind, 7 billion mind, sociality, and we cross the street and we feel instantly connected, instantly in touch with the person we see, like if it's our friend. We are going against our brains, because our brains are developed to have self, to become with these reasons, with these myths about the world, and to have fears about people that we don't know. But if we train enough, and we learn how to put our fears on the side, and connect with the people around us, I think it will be probably, I mean, it will be a more peaceful war. It could be a war with much more love, and we will be more happier. If happiness is what you value, we will be happier. I value peacefulness. I value love. So just by meditating, by getting in contact with ourselves, to understand ourselves, to realize the good parts of ourselves, the bad parts, the parts that works, the parts that doesn't work so correctly, we can be more truthful, maybe, to ourselves. And maybe we find this super meaning of reducing suffering in everyone. And yeah, many problems could be solved. But it's our responsibility. Like, the world is changing a lot, and technology is changing our lifestyles. So we really need to become responsible and to try to spread this feelings and to become practical in this, to find ways, to find strategies, to understand how all this works, how all this spirituality works, to put it into practice, and to change the world, because this is about, how are you? This is about, yeah, I mean, animals can speak with us, and many times we cannot speak with each other. And it's really sad, because we have language, and now we have technologies to really communicate. But still, we are messing up many things. I mean, we are doing correctly on the long term, and we are on the right way, but we mess up a lot. So we could really work on ourselves, work on the ways we communicate, be more open, be more sincere, be more truthful, and put our best, and then get the meaning of our lives thanks to reducing the suffering in this world. So yeah, I invite you to meditate, to understand, start understanding yourself. Meditation is a tool of knowledge about yourself.